I've said it before and I'll say it again. Repossession reality shows are some of the best in the genre. You've got shows like Operation Repo, which I will cover at some point, don't worry. I'm working on it. Then you've got Airplane Repo, which is a show where they repossess airplanes and any other object you can own. And then of course you've got Lizard Lick Towing, which I've covered before and we're gonna cover again today. Some of you may remember we covered the episode with the Lizard Lick Chicken Picken, which... that was a doozy. Now, it has been a while since I've covered this show, and mainly the reason is it's hard to find an episode of this show that doesn't have an overarching plot that spans like 8 episodes. I'm sorry for not thinking that was a thing with this show. I think I just got really lucky with the Chicken Picken episode, and that just being an episode where they wanted to hang back, have a Chicken Picken, not repo any cars. Spoiler alert, they repoed a car.
I'm gonna try to tow this back to the lot and get back here without anybody noticing.
It's just in their blood, they couldn't help it. And also, of course, there was a fight on the ground that ensued. There is not a show on True TV where there is not a fight that just happens on the ground. Now, the episode we're gonna be watching today is not the one I originally sought out after. That one will come later. I found this one in the meantime, though. After reading the synopsis, I couldn't help myself. I really wanted to watch this one. So without further ado, Lizard Lick Towing.
I told you that Bobby was lying and that he was hanging out with that girl.
Yeah, this was that overarching story that I was talking about. Apparently Bobby, I get them mixed up all the time. Apparently Bobby is mixed up with some chick that is just bad news, and I'm pretty sure it's only been like 2 or 3 episodes since the one we covered last time. And also I'm pretty sure the entirety of this show is just Bobby dealing with either this woman or someone else that's just bad news. I think that's just his character. So some of that will come up through this episode, but there's also a lot of other hijinks that ensue that hopefully will not deal with her.
How about I'm right behind you? No, if you want to talk about me, go ahead.
Let's be real, Bobby is not sneaking up on anyone. He is one of the 3 biggest men in this state.
I'm dying to know what you're talking about.
No conversation.
Bullshnut. What's wrong, you going mute? You can't speak? You got the evil eye. You're speaking loud enough with your eyes, but you can't say nothing.
Come on, bud. Let's do some skips, B. Come on. It's gonna be like 2 fat rats fighting a wool sock in a song.
Huh?
Amy got hotter than 40 acres of burning stump when she saw you with Mickey and feels like you've been lying to us and...
That was one hell of a run-on sentence. Man, all this Lizard Lick Towing's got me hungry. I really wish I was wearing a different shirt and a hat right now, but... That's so stupid. That's impossible. The technology doesn't exist, and I simply don't think I can. Man, you know. Let's thank the sponsor of today's video, HelloFresh. Longtime friends of the channel, HelloFresh are America's #1 meal kit, bringing you fresh, pre-portioned ingredients with easy-to-prepare recipes right to your door. They take the hassle out of cooking, while still actually being cooking. You're not left with a ton of unused ingredients that, let's be honest, are just going to rot in your fridge. Don't lie to me, I know when you're lying to me. So not only are you saving money, but you're also cutting down on waste. Sick. HelloFresh has easy-to-follow, foolproof recipes, so no matter what your cooking experience is, you'll have no problem putting these meals together. Because if I can do it, then, you know what, I'm not gonna dog myself, I'm really good at cooking, but these meals are actually very easy and stress-free. I like taking a break from normal cooking to do these because it's just so much of a stress-free experience, and the meals come out just as good as if I just went out and bought all the ingredients myself. They also have a ton of variety with 40 recipes and over 100 seasonal convenience items to choose from each week, so there's options for everyone with every lifestyle. So if you want to check out HelloFresh for yourself, use my link or go to HelloFresh.com and use code POGCHRISJUL50 for 50% off plus free shipping. And once you click, my description will live update to count up the purchases. I do hope you guys check them out. I love HelloFresh. I love when they sponsor me. But anyways, now back to the video. I'll have what he's having. I agree. Let's watch some more Lizard Lick Towing.
So is this like all you gonna do all day?
So now that we got Bobby's girl problems out of the way, it's time to get on to the first repo, which is the most interesting of the bunch today.
Dude, she is an escort.
Hold on, I need some carbohydrates for that.
How long do you think that bag of half-eaten popcorn has been up there on Ronnie's shelf for?
We'll get a hotel room.
You're gonna call her up and hire her for the night.
While you're in there distracting her...
Bobby's fucking face just listening to this plan unravel.
I'm gonna take the car out of there. As soon as I'm out of the parking lot, I'll key you up and you can tell her, hey, we just repoed your car, sorry.
Oh boy.
Well, if I have to...
Hey, this is...
I'm just lonely guy looking for a little company.
Tell her you got a foot fetish.
I understand.
I've got a room at the... kind of where I can get away, and I'm hoping maybe you can as well.
He's done this before. He's definitely done this before.
This repo should be a piece of cake, just as long as she looks like a picture. Just in case you slip, though, did you bring a parachute?
A negative. The double negative. No.
That's because Bobby fucks Raw. I'm sorry. I don't want to put that image in anyone's head. And now it's seared into mine. I would say scrap that. Don't scrap that.
I'm telling you, I am slicker than goat's not.
Think about the good Ronnie could do for this world if he took that chunk of his brain that is dedicated to just sayings nobody has heard of or doesn't make any sense, and he just used that for good.
So all you gotta do is put on that Bobby Brantley charm for 10 minutes, no, 5 minutes, and I'm done. I'm in and gone, baby.
Also, do me a favor. I want you to put that camera up in that room so you can film everything that happened.
So now the plan is in action. Bobby is in the hotel room getting ready to not have sex with an escort, and the escort is pulling up. Ronnie's then going to swoop in, take the car, and then hopefully everything else after that goes as planned.
This girl right here could run a bulldog off the back of a meat wagon at lunchtime. She got legs that goes on for days, baby. Ain't no hookers look like that.
What if it's a fucking cop? Like, this is a sting operation, and then Bobby just gets arrested?
Hey, girl, how you doing?
Oh, no, you're Bobby from Lizard Lick Towing. Oh, God, I gotta go get my car. So at this point, Bobby is very comfortable in this situation and not handling it awkwardly at all.
Just talk to me.
And Ronnie is just absolutely kicking ass with the repo outside. You mind fucking putting that camera down and helping me?
You're very attractive.
Thank you. Whoa, girl, you touching me again?
Watch, it's not even like the sting operation with the police and like prostitution or anything. Just Chris Hansen walks out of the closet. I would tell you to have a seat, but it looks like you've already made yourself at home on the bed. I see you even brought your own camera.
Wait, what?
Now, what were your intentions with this 13-year-old girl?
Ronnie, I need you to get the fuck in here. I don't know what the hell's going on.
Oh, don't you worry. We're dealing with Ronnie.
Ronnie's just, like, handcuffed on his belly in front of the hotel room with, like, 8 cops.
All right, Bobby, I'm out of there, Bo.
Is that your phone?
You can cut it up. The gig's up, Bo.
Why is there a camera?
Oh, God damn it! Is that a true TV camera? I knew some shit was going on.
Thanks for a lovely evening.
My daddy always says,
it ain't no boy when you're chasing a whore.
Huh? So now after that whole fiasco, we're back at the office and tensions are still high. We still got that whole issue with Bobby and his woman, and, well, things are not well. I love Ronnie just sitting there not knowing what to do.
This girl right here could run a bulldog off the back of a meat wagon at lunchtime.
Okay, I can leave if y'all can't.
Hookers.
Well, look here, we need to get this book out the back of this car.
Hey, well, I can't get you anything. I might can get her something, but I can't get you nothing.
Wait a minute, you little hoe, you.
Little hoe.
That true TV acting right there. Wait, hold on, you little hoe, you. Yeah, just, whatever.
No words out of you.
What you gonna be ugly to her for?
Because I want to.
Well, your woner's getting ready to get broke.
Good money, you will come work for me too.
These must be real people saying the true TV lines, because not only did he say that one line bad, he's also looking into the camera and doing that little side smile. This man is not SAG.
Hey, I'm gonna go ahead and tell you right now, you need to get up off of her.
Hey, boy,
don't even be messing with her.
I like how you got this guy out here causing a ruckus, and rather than send the two biggest men in Louisiana out to take care of it, she just comes out. Although I think that's the point, though. I think it's like, she doesn't take any shit, and she can handle this, which she kind of does. I don't know.
Don't be letting him back you in no corner like that. Oh, really?
You know this camera crew just wishes they would either get an add-on, maybe upgrade to a bigger waiting room, office area, something, so they're not just constantly ass to dick all the time.
We can call 911 and get you toted off. It don't make me no difference.
I got his 911 right here.
Amy, you're talking a lot of shit for being 0-1 in this fight right now. You did not win that one. So usually the way that these episodes work is something big happens in the first third of the episode, and then the second is the follow-up to what happened then, or the backlash. And then now we're on to the final repo mission. I can't wait.
I got an interesting repo for you.
Imagine that.
This guy's got an old Ford Ranger, and he's turned this thing into a monster truck. I heard it's all tricked out.
How are we gonna repo a mud bogger?
So when he said that at first, I thought, wait, haven't I already watched an episode of the show where they did repo some kind of mudding vehicle? And then after scrubbing through all of my videos, I remembered that on the episode of Airplane Repo, the show where they repo airplanes, they recovered a mudding vehicle.
That's like saying, hey, go to the dog pound and pick up my dog, but you don't tell me what your dog looks like. So you got 75 dogs out there.
Ronnie's pissed. There must be something else going on, because I feel like he's done worse, but he seems like this is the end of the world. If anyone can do this, it's Lizard Lick Towing.
Dude, have you thought, really sat back and thought about how dangerous this is? Because, I mean, this here bow is pretty much like strapping a banana to your butt and jumping in an 8-pin.
I guess I never really thought about it that way.
We're going to be dealing with big dumb boys and their big dumb toys.
Isn't that just this show in a nutshell? So now the boys are going to do some reconnaissance, since, like they said, they have no information on this vehicle other than the make and model of it, which, as we also know, this vehicle's been heavily modded, so I guess they're going to try and scout through the woods and figure this out.
We need to get a little closer. We can't see what they got.
Why they're revving them up? Go cross right now.
Watch, they just run into the Mountain Monsters crew and just get blown away.
We got to get where we can see what they're driving.
Exactly, that's what I'm trying to do.
You know, watching these guys play pretend like this, the same thing with Mountain Monsters and even Airplane Repo, it makes me really want to see Luxury Pranks, Luxury Dark, whatever. I want to see those two guys with a true TV budget. I want to see them just go hog wild with that. I think that would be better than any of these shows combined.
Hold up, one of them's about to go on a run. Let's see where he's going. How you gonna be in that thing right there, bro? That thing's dirtier than your ex-wife.
And Slimy's your current one.
Why would you say that?
Spoke, this ain't it.
Well, I mean, the gate was open, man. Didn't nobody say I couldn't be down here the gate?
Wow, the way that Ronnie just cleared that fence, I did not think he was capable of such feats.
Got somebody else heading to your truck.
Whoa, dude!
You gotta admit, that's kind of hot. Seeing them all rolling in the mud together like that. Not what I expected out of this episode, but I'll take it. And once again, a true TV repo show, everyone's gonna end up on the ground in a fight at some point. It just has to happen. And while in the last one, it was a whole bunch of grown men wearing camo, so you couldn't really tell who's who, now everyone's covered in mud, so we really can't tell who's who. It really is just always one of those, like, cartoon fight clouds with arms and legs kicking out from the sides. I think something happened off script, because look at Ronnie is, like, actually out of it. I think someone really hit him.
Get back in there, you, buddy!
Get back!
Hold on!
Back away!
Yeah, someone definitely kicked him in the side of the head.
Oh, my God.
Come on!
I'm coming.
Oh, fuck.
Come on.
You know, Bobby's knocked me out.
Oh, it was fucking Bobby. God damn.
Get no truck today, huh?
Nobody get out of here.
We need to get out of here, but that's in the mud. Nobody want to get mud. Y'all want some mud?
You'd think they'd be pretty welcoming to a true TV camera crew, but they're like, no, we don't want none of that. Get the fuck out of here.
Whoa, 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 bro. I am not getting in my truck like this.
I can't help that.
We gotta have some water or something.
Bobby, I think we're gonna have to take off our clothes and go swim in a creek together. It's the only way we're gonna be clean enough to get in these trucks.
Where are you going?
Shut up!
Where are you going?
Shut up!
Where are you going?
Shut up!
I'm with you. I know exactly where you're going.
Only took 3 times to get it through his thick, concussed skull.
I ain't getting that nasty water.
What are you doing?
Get the mud off of me. What does it look like?
So while that may have been a bust, it's time for us to wrap up the episode with some overarching plot, of course.
I'm trying to look up some stuff.
You gonna tell me what this is about?
Hey, Ronnie, wanna get licked?
What's she in there hollering about?
Whoa.
That is hot.
Well, I know exactly who that is.
Who?
It's Mickey. I mean, can't
oh,
you tell?
Oh, it is not, Amy. Do you see her face?
Do you see her hooters?
Yeah.
She's the only nasty slore that I know that would send a message like that and send it to Ron.
So yeah, we wrap up this episode with apparently Mickey, Bobby's fling, sending a provocative message to Amy, addressed to Ronnie, to stir up the pot. I thought maybe we'd get a resolution, but no, they just kind of storm off and the episode ends. Maybe I'll watch the next 17 episodes and we'll get a conclusion to this whole storyline. That sounds like a lot of work and a lot of hurt. So yeah, I hope you guys did enjoy us taking a look at this episode of Lizard Lick Towing. I always have to take a second before I say it because I want to say the Chicken Picken afterwards. If you did, like, comment, share with your friends. It all helps me out a ton. If you're new here and you enjoyed, consider subscribing. Hitting the notification bell helps me out a ton. Go follow me on Instagram, Twitter, Chris the James, everywhere. And with all that being said, thank you again for watching, and I will see you guys next time. Goodbye. Chris James. Chris James.